Hi guys, I'm back with another panned haul project make today, and we've got another one of these small jigsaw puzzle boxes. And again, I've black gessoed that because it gives it a nice thick coating. Yeah, I mean, you can see the wood stain through that, and that gorgeous look. So I'm going to keep it like that. I like that effect. We're going to do more or less the same as in the other one, but we're doing different projects. So what I've done, we're going to make a peacock shadow box today. So I've cut out a piece of paper for the inside. This is off of the graphic 45 paper, but I thought that would be really nice because it's got the peacock colours and feathers, though you won't see much of this paper. So we're going to stick that inside, and I'm just going to use a little bit of glue now, so I can get this glue open, and just stick that down. If this doesn't open, then get another glue. Ah, there we go. Yeah, I love these little shadow boxes, little wooden shadow boxes. Gorgeous, they are great things. Just make sure you get plenty of glue in the corners, because they do come up after a while otherwise. Right, so we've got a lot of glue on there. Slide it in and down. This one was cut a little bit shorter than the edges, so let me just eyeball that. Just pull it up and down. And then just go around it with your finger tip. Any of them glue bits don't show you there. Right, so that's it, my centre now. So that's that part done. So that looks nice like that as well. Now, I've got this circle here. This is out of an old set. And I want to decorate this, and I've got a MDF. I think that's another 84 round shape, and I'm going to have it like this, so it just prongs up the piece that I'm putting in the centre. So we're going to be working, we'll leave that to dry, and we're going to be working on this part. So I've got plenty of colours here. These are the colours that I've gone for, because of the nature of the subject is a peacock, I've gone through these colours. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with this colour, which is emerald green. It's a gorgeous colour. It's not too bright and it's not too dark. So I'm doing that as a base, and then I will put some other colours on. Okay guys, I've taken the lid off of that. I'm not sure if you can see that, Shane. Lovely. But this paint would be perfect for this project. Touch it up now and get it painted. We'll add some more paint when that's dry. Okay guys, I'm back again. I'm just putting this down so I can see. Right, so I'm going to use some of this purple. I love these sparks. I'm just going to put a little bit of different colours everywhere. I've got a little bit of purple here. I know I do like this pattern as well, but I do need this to go up a bit. That's the problem with this. So I am still going to put this in. Plus it breaks that colour a little bit. So I'm just going to use some of this really tacky glue to put this on. It will do it. Now, what I wanted to do, I have painted a couple of these. So let me just move that up there a minute because I'm going to need this. I want to put a bit of colour on these as well. Right, let me just leave them up there. So what we've done now is because we've glued it on our shadow box, I'm going to need some heavier glue to put in the round shape that we've just coloured. We need a bit of heavier glue on it, so I'm going to use some heavy body gel to put that down. That's fine. Now it's gone through the holes, but there's nothing I can do about that at the moment. Plus I need some glue on there to stick out anyway. And I'll show you why in a minute. I just want to make sure that's all pressed down firmly. Okay, now we can wipe a couple of the little pieces away. But I do want some of the blobs in the holes, and there's a reason. A little tray here, I'm going to put some beads down. I usually do this when I've finished a project, but I'm going to do it now while that glue's still wet. So these are the Daily Arts glass beads, and they've got beautiful, they're like iridescent, so I want to get some around it, shake off them ones and go around again. That's done. Put it that way. I'm going to work on this, which is the pendant, and I'm going to paint that, leave it to dry a bit, and then do the same thing, go in with extra colours in paint to start with, and then go on with the wax. Just finished this, just want to make sure that it's dry enough. It still looks a bit tacky, but that's fine. So I went over it in this trying to think of the colour emerald, and then I used some of these ink golds to colourise. It's alright, everything's been fine about in here. All these ink gold colours on the top, so it's got that two-tonal look. We've got our little bees on in the background. I'm not sure if you can see them when they hit the light. Like, it will do once that glue dries. They're like an opaque, but they're also as shimmery as a diamond. They're really nice. I had a set and they were in there, them beads, and I don't know where else I can buy them, but I do love them little beads. And they are proper glass beads, they're not acrylic. Right, now we've finished this. Hasn't that come out beautiful though? Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? See, you could put that on for a necklace. I mean, or extra large earrings. So what we're going to do is we're going to stick that onto there. So let me just see. So I won't bother sticking the bottom bits. That's just what I wanted to say. I've got this off of Amazon recently. It's a peacock design. They do like a screaming call. Right, okay, so that is done. It's just got to dry out. I'm hoping that will stay, but there we go. That is done, and I will take a picture outside because it's very shadowy in here, even though I've got two lights on at the moment, plus the camera light. It's absolutely gorgeous. So we'll leave this to dry for a bit and then I will show you the finished result.